Hey guys, it's Dante here. Today's video I'm gonna show you some of my favorite text effects. Please, if this helps you, don't forget to subscribe, leave a like, comment. Now let's go with effects. The first one is one that I started using lately. It's a crazy text effect, but I like it. So I'm gonna teach you how to do it. First of all, you're gonna add a text and you're gonna type whatever you want. So in this case, I'm gonna type crazy. Because I don't know, the text effect sounds me like something crazy, I don't know. The first text, you're gonna move it to the top. You can customize or do whatever you want. Increase the text, I don't know, that's on you. Now you're gonna duplicate it, and the following one you're gonna type another thing or the same, but in this time not in capital letters. I hope you got me. And you customize as much as you want. And then you're gonna do it the same, but like copy and paste those two texts. And you're gonna try to fill the whole screen with that. So add as much as you want, that's on you. There is not a specific things you're gonna do here. So the next thing, you're gonna press P in your keyboard and click the clock. Then you're gonna move it to the left or to the right, the text. Also, if you need more text, you can also copy and paste it, the text, as much as you want, so you have more text. And you can move it more to the left or to the right, or whatever you wanna move it. Okay, so as you can see, also you can fix up some things and right click to the position, and you're gonna click separate dimensions. We are gonna just need the X position, so we're gonna just play with that. In this case, you're just gonna follow me, do it like I do. So now you're gonna copy those frames. And be careful, try to copy it right, because if you don't copy it right, you can see that the whole text is moving. So you just need the X position. You try to select it carefully. And now you're gonna paste it there. So as you can see, just the following text, it's just moving to the left in this case. It's just moving to the left and not moving the whole thing. You can also add more text to your texts. Also here you can also move it a little bit so it doesn't go that uniform. You can move it a little bit. I don't know, I always do that, like I don't want it looks that uniform. So yeah, that already looks cool. So the next thing we're gonna do is do it the same but to the other side with the other texts, like the other part. You're just gonna play with X, do it to the other side. You can add more texts if you need. You're gonna copy those frames to all your next texts. You got me. I feel like I'm explaining like shit. Just like that. Okay, that's it. The next thing, you're gonna pre-compose all your texts. Control Shift C if I don't remember it wrong. And now you're gonna add the effect Turbulent Displays. So now you can play with those settings, or you can also copy me. I don't try to make it like I try to make it soft, not that hard. Just like that, for me it's cool. It looks crazy already and I like it. So well, that's it. You can also play as much as you want with the settings. But well, I hope you like it, and now we're moving to the next text effect. Please leave a like if you are already liking this video. If you don't like my voice, also leave a like. Let's go to the next text effect. So, well, this is a 3D effect and it looks really cool. It's a little bit kind of complex, but not too much, don't worry. So now let's learn how to do it. So let's create a new solid. Ok. Now press S in your keyboard and we're gonna click this button. And we're gonna decrease this option around 1 or 2, 3, that's on you. And well, with another option, we're gonna increase around 400. Then create a text. And now type whatever you want. In my case, the whole text will be I love you. So the first stick or the first solid will be with I, then and the next one love, and the last one with you. So well, turn off the 3D to both of your layers. And now you're gonna create a null and a camera. Put your camera below your null, turn on the 3D mode to your null, and now sync your camera with your null. Now press P in your null, you're gonna click the clock and the beginning, of course, and then you're going to the end of the effect or the end of everything. Now decrease this option around 4000, it's like a zoom out. As you can see, it looks pretty shitty. Oh well, now you're gonna press R in your null and you're gonna click the clock, Z, and at the end of the effect you're gonna put 180 or 360, that's on you. I always put it on 180, you can follow me if you want. So well, now it has like a rotation and that's way more cooler. Now you're gonna select all your frames, gonna press F9 in your keyboard, and now let's go to the graphs and try to do what I do. You can also play with the graph as much as you want till you're happy. Okay, now check it again. Well, it looks nice. So now I want the text appears from the camera. Like I want the text don't show like that. I want it appears from the front and then from the back, like to the back. So well, play with the options till you're happy. As you can see here, the eye appears from nothing, and I actually don't like that. So you can reposition it so the text appears from a side, from one side. That's way more cooler. Okay, so now the next thing, or well, the next word is I love. Oh, sorry. The next word is love. So now you're gonna select both of your layers, the text and the solid, and gonna duplicate that with Ctrl D. Now put it on the top of your last text and solid. So well, in this case, we're gonna make it appear from the camera again, from the front. So you just have to play with that. And also you can play with the rotation of it, so it looks way more better. And this time it won't be I, it will be I love. It will be love. Again, it appears from nothing and I don't like that. So I reposition it so it doesn't appear from nothing. It in this way it looks way more cooler because you see from one side. Yeah, okay, that's cool. And then with the U, so it's literally the same process, so I'm not gonna repeat that. So well, as you can see, it looks cooler. Don't forget to turn your motion blur. So well, that looks really cool right now. So yeah, that's it. It looks really cool. You can reposition it, do whatever you want, you know. so well for N if you want, but of course I cannot show you right now. But if you got a plug in particular, you can put it on it. It will make it look way more better. Yeah, just like that. And also you can put optical flares. That will make it look way, way more cooler. Well, that's everything I teach you today. So, well, I hope you like it. Please leave a like, subscribe, comment, share it. And that's it. See ya.